A very good morning, students. I hope you all are healthy and fine. Now, today we will start with the fourth chapter of An Alien Handbook, and the name of the chapter is The Cop and the Anthem. Now, first of all, I would like to ask you that whether you have ever found yourself in a situation in which what happened was the opposite of what you expected. Yes? This happens many a times, like what we are expecting, the things happen just opposite of that. So this story is all about those situations. Soapy was a young man who lived in a park because he had no home or job. Winter was around the corner. The trees had begun shedding their leaves. Soapy realized that he would need a warm, comfortable place to stay in. He thought that the prison in Blackwell's Island is just that best place to spend the winter. He could stay at a shelter, but he did not like answering personal questions. At the prison, he was assured of free food and a bed during three cold winter months. After all, for years it had been his home during the winter months. Soapy began planning ways to get arrested so that he was sent to prison. He decided to have dinner at a popular restaurant and then apologize for not having money to pay. The restaurant staff would call a policeman and get Soapy arrested. The judge would then sentence Soapy to 3 months in prison. With this plan in mind, Soapy entered a famous restaurant on Broadway. But the head waiter noticed Soapy's torn shoes and pants and sent him out of the restaurant. Disappointed, Soapy began thinking of another plan. He threw a large stone through the glass window of a big shop on 6th Avenue. A few people and a cop came running to the front of the shop. Soapy smiled at the cop, hoping he would arrest him. He confessed that he had broken the glass window, but the cop refused to believe Soapy. Instead, the cop chased a man running on the street. Once again, Soapy was heartbroken. Then Soapy saw an ordinary restaurant across the street. After eating a huge dinner at the restaurant, Soapy said that he had no money to pay. He told the waiters to call the police, but two of the waiters picked him up and threw him out of the restaurant. A policeman who saw the scene laughed at Soapy and walked away. Disappointed, Soapy started walking till he reached an area that had many theaters. He began shouting loudly as if he was drunk. He even danced and cried out. Watching his behavior, a policeman dismissed him as a college boy who was allowed to shout. Soapy was sad, thinking that it didn't seem like he would be sent to prison after all. Then he saw a man buying a newspaper from a shop. The man had kept his umbrella next to the door. Soapy picked up the umbrella and walked away. The man followed Soapy and asked him to return the umbrella. Soapy asked the man to call the police. Seeing a policeman, the man hesitated. He apologized for mistaking it to be his umbrella and walked away. Soapy was so angry that he threw the umbrella as far as he could. Tired and disappointed, Soapy started walking back to his seat in the park. On the way, he stopped at a house in a quiet corner. This was his childhood home. He could see a soft light shining through a window. The beautiful music floating out of the house made Soapy nostalgic. He remembered the happy days at home with his mother and his friends. He thought of the good life he had led then. Soapy's soul underwent a transformation. He realized how he had wasted his time chasing wrong desires. He was filled with fear, remembering how he had lost all his willpower and hope. He decided to change his life and become a man of worth. He remembered the man who had offered him a job, and he decided to meet the man the next day and turn around his life by working hard. Just then, a policeman asked Soapy what he was doing standing in front of the house. When Soapy said nothing, the policeman refused to believe him. The policeman took Soapy with him. The next morning, the judge sentenced Soapy to 3 months of imprisonment on Blackwell's Island. I hope, students, you all have understood the story well. Thank you so much and stay blessed.